Despite being an amazing, near-universal phenomenon, there's still a lot of speculation around the orgasm's function and value. But what are the differences between male and female orgasms that we know of, and who has it better? To start, the length of a woman's orgasm is longer than men, lasting around 20 seconds or more, while most males tend to last around 3 to 10 seconds. But men have more orgasms. In a National Australian Survey of Heterosexual Sex, researchers found that men had an orgasm in 95% of encounters, while women did only 69% of the time. However, orgasms might have less to do with gender and more to do with the types of sex you're having. For example, a study of single Americans aged 21 to 26 found that while straight and gay men's rate of orgasm is similar, the rate of orgasm for women varies significantly by sexual orientation. Lesbians have around 12% more orgasms than straight women during sex, with 25% of gay women saying they climaxed with every sexual experience, and almost half saying they climaxed over 75% of the time. This may be related to the duration of sexual encounters, as lesbian couples report an average length of 30 to 45 minutes in comparison to the average 15 to 30 minutes by straight women. Other explanations point to genetics. A study of 4,000 female twins found that genetics predicts a third of the probability that a woman orgasms during sex. But what about the way an orgasm feels? A study of college students asked men and women to describe their experience of an orgasm, and then later took out the words related to specific genitals, and it turns out that there was very little distinguishable difference between the sexes. Regardless of your gender, the brain stimulates blood flow to the genitals and your heartbeat and breathing increase. And while PET scans show significant differences in activation patterns during sexual arousal, brain activity during an orgasm itself is the same between men and women. The lateral orbitofrontal cortex, which controls self-evaluation, reason, and control, shuts down in all genders, which makes sense as you often lose control during an orgasm. And the similarities don't stop there. Both genders get drowsy after orgasm due to the surge in the sleepy hormone prolactin. Interestingly, 4 times as much prolactin is released after intercourse compared to orgasm achieved via masturbation, meaning you don't get as sleepy after a solo session. And while we once thought that spontaneous orgasms during sleep, otherwise known as wet dreams, were only for men, one study reports that 37% of women have had nocturnal orgasms, and 30% had had one in the past year. Even multiple orgasms, a phenomenon thought to be exclusively for women as they lack a refractory period, has been seen in men as well. Though male orgasms generally happen simultaneously with ejaculation, research has documented that men are capable of non-ejaculatory orgasm that can occur prior to as well as after ejaculation. This shared experience of the orgasm makes sense from an evolutionary perspective. Just like when you see someone cry and feel sad for them because you understand it, observing or being part of a partner's orgasm can enhance the desire and experience of your own. If we had completely different orgasms, that same connection wouldn't be there. At the end of the day, while sexual arousal may be different between men and women, major differences in orgasm experience likely come down to the individual level. Differences in physiology, anatomy, and our psychology play a huge role. So get to know your own body to optimize your sexual experiences. You can always learn even more about sexual pleasure during your solo sessions in our video, Is Masturbation Good for You? Link in the description below. And a special thanks to Audible for supporting this episode to give you a free 30-day trial at audible.com/ASAP. This week we wanted to recommend the book, But What If We're Wrong?, which questions everything we think we know in today's world and how it might appear to those in the far future. Pretty neat. You can get a free 30-day trial at audible.com/ASAP and choose from a massive selection. We love them as they're great when you're on the go. And subscribe for more weekly science videos.